Turkana County has hosted the refugees for over 25 years. And during this period, the local people have witnessed several issues relating with refugees. The first one is that the modeling of Kakuma refugee camp did not take care of the needs of those who are hosting the refugees themselves.
Right.
At the same time, also, the modeling of the Operation Lifeline Sudan hub in Lokichogio that was providing relief efforts into South Sudan was also devoid of its environment. Mm-hmm. So the people of Turkana are very welcoming. And normally, for families that have problems, those who have will always support them through the traditional coping mechanisms.
Right.
So when refugees were coming, and the government of Kenya was requesting for space, the people saw people fleeing from their countries who needed support. So they welcomed them and settled them in Kakuma.
Yeah, well, it always strikes me that 85% of the world's refugees are in developing countries like Kenya, not in the richer parts of the world. But I want to talk a little bit about you, because before you were a politician, you were a businessman, and you were also a humanitarian. You worked for the World Food Program in the then Sudan. When you saw and you worked with and met your first displaced person, what did that mean to you, and how has that influenced your career?
Melissa, let me just mention that I come from the southern part of this county, a place since the 40s that I've seen tremendous depopulation due to insecurity related to cattle hustling, but also drought, chronic drought situations that force people out. Mm. So that's my background. So I also happen to work with humanitarian organizations in South Sudan, in Eritrea, and I experienced firsthand the problems which displaced people will go through due to frequent fighting. Mm. And so that gave me the background. So when I came back to work in my county and I got elected, I thought that that situation ought to change. And that situation also has to integrate with the need to elevate the certain similar problems which local communities were facing that were similar to refugees.
Right.
If you come to Turkana community, you will find the same problems of education, the same problems of health,
right,
problems of water shortage, which is almost similar to what refugees are also experiencing, on top of the bigger political and insecurity problem that has forced them to leave their countries. So this provided me the opportunity to be able to guide my people, to be able to speak to HCR, to be able to speak to the national government, to see how we can be able to develop a program that is going to be not only supportive to refugees, but also provides the support to local communities in a way that they live as a community. And hence, the Kakuma settlement was born. And in fact, the local people gave the land freely on the hope that the program that is going to be modeled, it is going to be a program that is going to be benefiting not only the refugees, giving them a home away from home, but equally providing support to the local host community that will be of value and make sure that the integration, both economically and socially, is something that can be sustained over the years.
I think we should give a hand to not only the governor, but also the people of Kakuma and Turkana County, who have welcomed 185,000 refugees into their community, even though they have so little, really. You know, the narrative around the world is that refugees are an economic burden. If countries welcome refugees, they do it mostly for humanitarian reasons, or they have an obligation under international law. In your case, you do it not just for humanitarian reasons, but you have been convinced also because of the reports from the World Bank that have shown the figures that actually refugees help you benefit your economy here. Tell us about that, and tell us what the rest of Kenya, what does the national government of Kenya think about what you're doing?
Indeed, when we came up with the idea of piloting the Kakuma settlement, we received a lot of accolades and support from both our colleagues in the national government, but all the development partners, that indeed this will be a better way of dealing with chronic refugee situations. And we thought that we should be able to move forward. The World Bank statistics are evident enough to indicate that this is not just a humanitarian program, but it is an economic program supporting the local economy. Indeed, in our county integrated development planning, we have integrated refugee affairs into that program so that we see it as beneficial to this economy. Mm-hmm. What we need out of Kakuma is to create more jobs, to create more businesses for both the host communities here and the refugees, and also to turn Kakuma into a municipality where we can be able to plan it to be a more organized urban area. That in the future, when the refugees, the home country stabilizes and they return back home, we will be left with an infrastructure that we can be able to sustain and make value and derive value out of it.
Let me stick with you there, because I, you know, we talked before too, and I was really struck that not only you really want to plan this community so it has lasting value for your constituents, but also you told me that you want to make sure that while the refugees are here and have found sanctuary in Turkana County, you want to help them prepare for their return home. Tell us about that.
Thank you. I think this is interesting because I derive this from my experiences working in South Sudan. Refugees, before they come here, may have, during their flight, been displaced twice, three times, five times. And the very unfortunate ones, even 10 times, if they're coming from very far, deep into South Sudan. So they come here with totally nothing. They have lost everything. And many of them are children. So the refugee settlement and camp should become the rehabilitation point to give these people hope and to give them skills they can be able to utilize once their country gains ground. If you speak to the local businesses and refugee business who have set up businesses, they look back home and see if there are opportunities for them to do the same very same business while back home. So I think these skills will be useful while here. These skills will also be useful while going back. Same thing with the communities around here in Kakuma. The skills benefited out of this relationship are skills that are going to help them grow and grow their local economy for the benefit of their families. And I think that integration, and particularly with the closeness, I give a very good example of South Sudan that is very closer here. The stability of South Sudan will enhance the economic linkages and the social linkages between that country and this part of Kenya. And it's going to be of much bigger benefit to not only the local people, but to the refugees who need, while in refuge, to have that dignity of being very close with communities that they work with.
Yeah. I think there's something like 2,000 businesses here in Kakuma. Can you describe what some of these businesses are and kind of give us a that was then and this is now kind of picture?
It would be very interesting. Within Kakuma town itself, before we created Kalobeye, there are two shopping business centers. One is outside the town along the main highway. The other one is inside the refugee camp. So all these are thriving, and there's a lot of interconnectivity between the businesses in the camp that are owned by entrepreneurial refugees and the businesses outside the camp, and even as far as Lodwar, Kitale, and Nairobi. So this, with the opportunities that have come up in Kakuma, that has provided much more opportunities to more businesses, not only the existing ones to expand, but the new ones to be able to come in. And I'm glad that IFC also conducted a very good survey here of the market, which has established that the potential of this market is probably almost a quarter of Nairobi City. And we think that there is room for the business community to be able to thrive here, not only in selling manufactured goods, but also selling goods that are going to be produced here. And I believe that Turkana, and particularly this area, has that potential of even producing more and more food and cash crops because of the existence of the largest underground water reservoir in Kenya, which is in the neighborhood of Kakuma.
Right, and we'll come back to that maybe in the last question, but I wanted to ask you, some of the issues in some of the richer countries in Europe and the United States and Australia is often the fear that people have about people arriving, refugees arriving, who bring a different culture. In the Kakuma refugee camp, we have 19 nationalities, I believe, many different religions. How do you get your people to accept this?
I think they have integrated socially because there's freedom of movement within Kakuma. The communities are integrating. They have also been participating in cultural events organized by local communities. Recently, we had a Tobonglore Cultural Festival that is normally attended by more than 10,000 people. We had integrated the refugee communities into it. But also, we participate in many social events that happen in the camp. I think above that, some of the refugees and the host communities have found love. Uh-huh. And some of them have made families out of this. And I think in Turkana tradition, this is not wrong. Mm. This is not wrong. But also equally appealing is at one point when we had issues within the camp, problems between one community and the other, those communities fled and were housed by the Turkana host community. And to me, I saw that was a very good sign of integration. Mm. So long as you remove the barriers, you remove the distinction between we and you, and that we are the same people, then it is easier to live together here and integrate. And of course, eventually the refugees will go back home. But I think we want that social connection to continue. I remember sometimes in Nairobi and in my visitations in Europe, I've met former refugees who've grown up here. But they have told me they have a connection with Kakuma. They will want one time to come back and give back to the community and to the refugees who are still in the camp. And I think that is a sort of social connection that we will want to grow out of this and develop so that even those who live here still feel this is home, this is where they have grown, this is where they went to school. And at one time when they prosper, they can be able to come back and give the other refugees remaining here.
Bravo.
Give back, but also to the community that are supporting them.
That's great. Well, I think that this was a very wonderful point to end. I think we should spread the Turkana tradition around the world, and the world will have more humanity for refugees.
Governor, thank you. We need that.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.